ओके सो लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैड डिस्कस्ड विद 15th चैप्टर दैट टाइम 15th चैप्टर वाज ओवर ओके सो ओनली टू चैप्टर्स आर रिमेनिंग बायोटेक्नोलॉजी सो चैप्टर नंबर 11 बायोटेक्नोलॉजी प्रिंसिपल्स एंड प्रोसेसेस Biotechnology deals with technique of using live organization organisms or enzymes. Here we are using two living organisms in these procedures. Fine. So here live organisms, here we are using the two organisms, one that is E. coli bacteria and another is bacteriophage. In E. coli bacteria, the most important thing is plasmid. Here in biotechnology process we are using the two living organisms, one that is E. coli bacteria and another one that is known as bacteriophage. I hope you know that what is the meaning of bacteriophage. Here in E. coli bacteria we are using the plasmid. So as you know that plasmid is circular psDNA. E. coli bacteria has its own DNA. Along with its own DNA, another extra circular DNA is present. And that circular DNA is dsDNA known as plasmid. And plasmid consists so many different genes for particular function. And now the next is bacteriophage. So what is bacteriophage? Actually, bacteriophage is bacteria affected by virus. So here in bacteriophage, one question was asked. Bacteria will die. One question was asking me that in bacteriophage, which organism will die? Bacteria will die. Because you know that the virus is poison, poisonous material. And here the virus can affect the bacteria. At last, bacteria will die. So, biotechnology deals with technique of using live organisms or enzymes from organisms to produce products and processes useful to human being. 12th chapter, I will tell you application of biotechnology. But here, actually, in biotechnology, what we can do, that we will learn this in this chapter. In this sense, making curd, bread or wine, which are all micro-mediated processes. 10th chapter, I have told to you that we are using so many microbes. By using these microbes, we are producing so many things. 10th chapter, we have discussed that curd, bread, toddy, that is traditional drink, cheese, enzymes, so many organic acids and biofertilizers. Could also be thought as a form of biotechnology. Micro-mediated, all the processes are now considered under biotechnology. Actually, the brief meaning of biotechnology is the technology which is developed by using the living organisms for useful to mankind. However, it is used in restricted sense today to refer to such of those processes which use genetically modified organisms. So now, the next MCQ, GMO. Okay, so we can change the genetic material of an organism. That organism is known as genetically modified organism, and the food is synthesized by modification in the gene is known as GMF, genetically modified food. To achieve the same on a large scale. Further, many other processes or techniques are also included under biotechnology. For example, in vitro fertilization, you know that here IVF. fertilization occurs outside of the body, so IVF, it is also known as test tube baby. Okay, you know that IVF, it is used in such couple in which female fallopian tube is blocked or male can release the less number of sperms. Okay, so in vitro fertilization leading to a test tube baby, and here in test tube baby artificial fertilization occurs inside the laboratory, inside the test tube, in a suitable cultural medium, whereas we can allow it to develop 3 to 5 days, and after 3 to 5 days we will remove this embryo from the test tube and implant in the uterus of mother. Then natural implantation occurs, and then further process are similar to natural one. Synthesizing gene and using it, developing a DNA vaccine, or correcting the defective gene, all are the parts of the biotechnology. Okay, so vaccine produced by the biotechnology, as well as we can correct the defective gene. Okay, fine. Now one more extra point, during formation of brain, you know that for formation of the brain or related products of brain, we will use Baker's yeast. This Baker's yeast known as Saccharomyces cerevisiae. Now the Saccharomyces cerevisiae yeast undergoes alcoholic fermentation process and produce the ethanol. Now after cooking the bread, after cooking the bread, if we will give the heat to bread, due to heat the ethanol present inside the bread, the major portion of it is vaporized, and little bit of bread remains, little bit amount of ethanol remains. Now listen the MCQ proper. As a result, this is the most important one. As a result, cooked bread is slightly sweetened in cooked bread. The cooked bread is slightly sweet in taste. Why? Due to presence of little bit amount of ethanol present inside it. Okay, so this is not given there. Now the most important thing, important MCQ, full form of EFB, European Federation of Biotechnology. European Federation of Biotechnology has given the definition of biotechnology that encompasses both traditional view and modern molecular biotechnology. The definition given by EFB is as follows. Integration of natural science and the organisms. So according to the European Federation of Biotechnology, the definition is integration of natural science and organism, cells, parts thereof, and molecular analogs for products and services. Okay, now the principles of biotechnology, it is skipped. Okay, principles of biotechnology, it is skipped. Now let me continue with the tools of recombinant DNA technology. Before taking this in detail, I want to tell you Okay. See. Biotechnology is also known as recombinant DNA technology. In short way, we say that small r DNA technology. So now, the most important one, tools of recombinant DNA technology. Now we know that from the foregoing discussion that here actually in biotechnology genetic engineering is included. Genetic engineering it is included here. Okay, in biotechnology. Now we know from the foregoing discussion that genetic engineering or recombinant DNA technology can be accomplished only if we have the key tools. Which are the key tools? Restriction enzymes, then polymerase enzyme, ligases, vectors. And most of the results. Okay, so here we are using the different tools in recombinant DNA technology are restriction enzymes, polymerase enzymes, ligases. Here restriction enzymes are using for cutting the DNA at a specific site. Polymerase enzymes can be useful for formation of the new DNA strand. Ligases, as you know that ligases enzyme it is used to join the DNA fragments. And these are the vectors. See, E. coli bacteria, plasmid. Plasmid of E. coli bacteria and bacteriophage are vectors, and host organism is E. coli bacteria majority. Let's see, discuss in detail one by one. First is restriction enzymes. In year 1963, the two enzymes responsible for restricting the growth of bacteriophage in Escherichia coli when isolated. One of these added methyl group to DNA, while other cut the DNA. So here two types of enzymes are seen. One can add the methyl group to DNA, one cut the DNA. The latter, it is known as restriction endonuclease enzyme. See, before reading the remaining things of this restriction enzymes, I want to tell you, restriction enzymes restriction enzymes are also known as scissors or scalpel of DNA. Helpful to cut the DNA at a specific site. Here, restriction enzymes are also known as restriction enzymes are also included in the group of nucleases and types of enzyme. And here, nucleases type of enzyme is of two types, exonuclease and endonuclease. Okay, exonuclease enzyme exonuclease enzyme cut the DNA at end region. So, from either end of the DNA, the nitrogenous bases are removed. Endonuclease enzyme cut the DNA from inside the DNA. So now here, this endonuclease enzyme is majority of two types. सी। एंडोन्यूक्लियस एंजाइम इज ऑफ टू टाइप्स। इफ एंडोन्यूक्लियस एंजाइम कट द डीएनए एट अ सिमेट्रिक मैनर ऑन बोथ द साइड्स ऑफ द डीएनए इट विल कट इन द सेम रीजन इट इज नोन एज ब्लंटेंड एंड व्हेन द एंडोन्यूक्लियस एंजाइम cut the DNA in asymmetric manner. This is known as TTM. But you remember that the restriction endonuclease enzyme which forms the sticky end, these are useful in biotechnology only. These are only useful enzymes in biotechnology. Remaining are not. Underline the first restriction endonuclease enzyme was discovered is HIND2. Whose function is dependent on specific DNA nucleotide sequence was isolated and characterized 5 years later. It was found that HIND2 always cut the DNA molecule at a particular point by recognizing specific sequence of a 6-base pair. तो यहाँ HIND2 enzyme है that can recognize or identify the 6 nitrogenous base pair in a particular way that cut the DNA at a specific region. This specific base sequence is known as recognition sequence of HIND2. So, dear all students, please turn the page and see the diagram. The diagram is of EcoR1. Later on I will tell you how the naming is given to these enzymes. EcoR1 means Escherichia coli R species second first number EcoR1. Escherichia coli R1 recognize the sequence of the DNA in this way GAATTC and opposite side in the reverse one that is GAATTC. When you move in the nitrogenous base sequence in one direction, okay, and when you read the codons on the opposite direction, the codes are same, it is known as palindromic chain. So restriction endonuclease enzyme recognized this palindromic chain and cut the DNA at a specific site. So in EcoR1, the DNA is cut. DNA is cut at the region between the G and A on the both the strands and form the sticky ends. beside hint 2 MCQ. Today we know more than 900 restriction enzymes. This is the most important line. Today we know more than 900 restriction enzymes that have been isolated from over 230 strains of the bacteria. So more than 230 bacteria, from them we isolate more than 900 restriction enzymes up to right now. So beside hint 2, today we know more than 900 restriction enzymes that have been isolated from over 230 strains of the bacteria, each of which recognize different recognition sequence. So here I can stop. Now, remaining things I will discuss this in next lecture.